I'm going to go through a few slides to give you a few pieces of information about the regional Center of Excellence Against Hunger and Malnutrition. I believe you went through some of the global challenges this morning, and it goes without saying that one of the global challenges the world is facing nowadays is hunger and malnutrition, which is on the rise. And I believe the linkage between hunger and malnutrition has been explained this morning in length. So I'm not going to go through it again. But if you don't mind, I would start out by saying that the regional Center of Excellence Against Hunger and Malnutrition actually came within that context where we are facing the rise of global hunger and malnutrition over the last 3 years. And if you look at this slide, it goes without saying that West Africa and Central Africa are among the lowest performers. You can clearly see that one in three children, what is going on? One in three children are suffering from chronic malnutrition. So it's not just about a short-term issue, but it's also linked to the structural issues. In this context, you would agree with me that one of the challenges that the development community is facing is if we don't put our forces together, it's very much going to be almost impossible that we can have any impact on achieving SDG 2 by the year 2030. Let me then give you maybe some update on how at the level of CERFAM, that's the acronym in French, Centre d'Excellence Régionale contre la faim et la malnutrition, what CERFAM is about. It's a partnership between the government of Côte d'Ivoire and the World Food Programme. But it's a partnership which is strategically positioned for the region, not for Côte d'Ivoire. It is a knowledge exchange platform to document and disseminate good practices against malnutrition and food insecurity. As of now, we are building a digital platform which is going to be the repository of those good practices. The platform is going to facilitate the adaptation and implementation of good practices through the mobilization and brokering of the deployment of expertise. And I believe I'm speaking to a wide crowd of expertise, which definitely could play a role in that. Let me give you very quickly what the CERFAM in terms of vision and mission is about. What you see on the screen here is a discussion that took place in June 2019 with 18 countries in the region, bringing together high-level experts like you, over 60 from 18 countries, to talk about what the center could be doing. One thing is to establish the center through a partnership. The other one is to make sure that it actually contributes to the initial intention which it was aimed for. Out of that discussion, it came out clearly that the center could eventually contribute to really the accelerating progress toward SDG 2 as a mission. And from there, the center envisions to becoming a catalyst, as you see on the screen, and an enabler to really capitalizing on the good practices against hunger and malnutrition. It's not about doing it, but it's about really mobilizing the expertise around the good practices with evidence of impact on hunger. malnutrition, so that when the expertise is identified and deployed, the countries or partners who demand for such good practices can actually have the expertise available to help implement the good practices. Now, to achieve the mission, the vision, and the strategic goal, the reflection also went around how do we achieve it. SurfArm is going to lean on four main pillars. One is partnership. I don't think I have to dwell too much on that. Partnership with all the stakeholders to make sure that together we can join forces to really deploy the support which is required for food security and nutrition. Research. Research is about capitalizing on the hidden knowledge which has not been implemented, some of which are very much innovative with potential but not yet known. So it's about promoting that. Technical assistance is about deploying, make the knowledge available, and make the expertise also known so that it can be deployed. And advocacy, joining forces so that we can disseminate what exists and make sure it's really being taken up by stakeholders. There are a few levels of programmatic areas that the center, with the regional consultation is going to focus on. One is community resilience. The other one is anything related to malnutrition. Another one on rural development and post-harvest loss management and the homegrown school feeding. I'm putting these ones out there because you will notice that all of them have to do with environmental impact, climate change, value chain development, local economy development, youth employment, women empowerment. Let me go quickly to the conclusion by saying that the approach of SurfArm is demand-driven. We don't necessarily go out, and I like very much the previous presentation, which was about the needs. So the demand will generate the type of support that can be provided. SurfArm is going to leverage on the coordination and the collaborative approach, definitely, not to do, but to broker the doing. And it's also about capitalizing on the knowledge management initiatives. So those are some of the things I wanted to share with you, and I hope you will visit our stand to interact with my colleagues who are in the room. Thank you very much. Yeah.